morning. I was wondering if there are any altar servers in the church this morning. If we have any altar servers in the church this morning, we would appreciate your help.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Timothy. Today is the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday. The celebrant for today's Mass is Father Ralph, assisted by Deacon Bob. The second collection today is for tuition assistance. If you have not yet signed up to have your picture taken for our parish directory, the sign-up sheets are available in the narthex. This weekend and next weekend are the last chances to sign up. The Chaplet of Divine Mercy will be today, Sunday, at 3 p.m., and there will be a rosary at 2:30 p.m. Please see the bulletin for more details. OCA envelopes are available at the entrances of the church. Thank you for your generosity. In respect for the Eucharist, please remember to silence your cell phones. The intentions for today's Mass are for Edward Hoffer and Norma Tona.
Good morning. Thank you for joining us today at St. Timothy's. Our opening song from the music issue is number 185, Jesus is Risen, number 185.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with all of you. Good morning, everyone. And happy Easter to all of you. We are celebrating the second Sunday of Easter, and this is the second Sunday, still within the octave of Easter. From the first Mass of Easter until evening prayer tonight, that's one solid celebration of the Easter Mass. So it's very appropriate to wish your friends and family, and I wish all of you, a very happy Easter. Today also we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday, when St. Faustina gave us the intention, Jesus, I trust in you. And we also welcome those who are watching us and celebrating with us on our live stream. We thank you for tuning in this morning, and we pray for the day that you can join us here in church and celebrate as one big, happy family. And so, brothers and sisters, as you know, during the Easter season, we get sprinkled with the holy water, blessed at the Easter Vigil, the water that recalls our baptism. During the Easter season, we begin Mass with the night rite of sprinkling, using the holy water blessed at the Easter Vigil. We recall the moment of baptism, when we first answered the call of the saints. Now let us place our trust in Jesus and ask him to wash away our sins. Dear brothers and sisters, we humbly beseech the Lord our God that this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us, as a memorial of our baptism, may he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Grant that we may share in the greatness of our brothers, our gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Springs of our birth, flood of God's riches poured on the earth. We are born from the darkness and clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God. Fountain of mercy, grace flowing free, streams of salvation spilling with love from a tree. River of glory, springs of our birth, flood of God's riches poured on the earth. We are born from the darkness and clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God. Here there is haven, healing and health, joy for the asking, love in abundance of wealth. River of glory, springs of our birth, flood of God's riches poured on the earth. We are born from the darkness and clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God.
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. And we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded to them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were each distributed according to their need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. I was hard pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. The stone which the builder rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we are loved, the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus Christ is Lord? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Rejoice and be glad in it, in it.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for the fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst, and he said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed him his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them, and he said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive and forgive them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with him when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples again were inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst, and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, and see my hands, and bring your hand, and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "Lord, my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Again, good morning to everyone. And before I begin my homily, I just want to give everyone a reminder that next Saturday, by this time next weekend, the church will have a new deacon, and St. Timothy will have a parishioner, a seminarian who is a deacon, next Saturday at 10 o'clock in Boca Raton at St. Joan of Arc Church. His Excellency, the Most Reverend Barbarito, is going to ordain the transitional deacons, those men who are becoming a deacon and the next year become a priest, and our own Bill Burns will be one of those. So Bill will be ordained next Saturday as a deacon, and we are very proud of Bill. That'll be Saturday. Then on Sunday, I have given Deacon Ron and Deacon Bob the day off, and then Deacon Bill will be here and will preach at both the masses, the 10, 9, and the 11. We will have donuts after 7 and 9, but we will have a reception for Bill after the 11. So if you'd like to hear Bill give his first homily as a deacon, we would invite you to please come to either the 9 or the 11 o'clock mass, and you can hear Bill preach, then stay after the 11 for a little bit of refreshment and go over and give him a hug and say hello and wish him well. We'll be praying for you this week, and I ask all of you to please pray for Bill as he receives his ordination to the diaconate. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. You have come to believe because you have seen me. This is the words Jesus said to Thomas when Thomas said, Christ standing in front of him, and Thomas said, "I ain't gonna believe that you're real. I think you're a ghost. I don't believe this." And Jesus says, see my hands, touch my side, put your hand in my side. This is John's version of the Pentecost. This is because right before that, Jesus appears before the disciples and says, "Peace be with you." Jesus is wishing the disciples peace because he is in relationship with them and he knows who they are. And they know who he is. And he knows what's coming next for them. And twice he says, "Peace be with you." And then, as John's gospel says, Jesus breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven, and whose sins you retain are retained. And in that moment, the church truly begins. Because no matter what gospel you look at, after they receive the Spirit, they go out into many different lands and many different languages, and they develop the church. And we've heard, and we will hear all of the stories out of the book of Acts of this building of the church. And through the entire Easter season, that's what our church does. Our church takes us through Acts and lets us see how the disciples went out and the problems they had and how they tried to build and do what Christ told them to do, taught them to do. Peace be with you. Receive the gift of the Spirit. When we're confirmed, the bishop or whoever's confirming says, receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Exactly the action that Christ did here, so every one of us through our confirmation receives the gift of that Spirit. And it's one that we take and we are to use to go out and be the hands and feet of Christ in the world today. We have so many opportunities here at St. Timothy, it's incredible. And the people here have been generous both with time and talent and treasure. The people here at St. Timothy's have done exactly what Christ asked us to do. We have received the gift of the Spirit, and we have taken it out, and we have done what he's asked us to do. Peace be with you. Today also we celebrate the Divine Mercy. When Pope St. John Paul II proclaimed that the second Sunday of Easter be called Divine Mercy Sunday, that we remember the words of St. Faustina, that poor religious nun who had a vision. And in it she wrote, Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. When things get to a point where we just can't deal with them, when things get to a point in our life when we are so frustrated, if we just take a moment and remember the picture, and I wish there was one out, I thought we would have one. We'll have one out for next year. But the picture of Christ with his hands extended and the light coming out from his heart. And it says, Jesus, I trust in you. When we say that, when we take a step back from our lives, from whatever's going on in the moment, if we take a step back and just remember the power of Christ in our life, the power of Christ in the world, the Spirit that we received when we were confirmed, when we remember Christ in that upper room saying to his disciples, peace be with you. When Thomas says, I don't believe, and Jesus says, fine, come and touch me. But you notice in the gospel, it never says he stuck his hand in Jesus' side. Jesus offered himself to Thomas, go ahead. And that's all it took for Thomas's eyes to be opened and for him to see Christ had risen. Christ was there standing with him. Brothers and sisters, as we continue this Mass, as we continue our journey through the Easter season, let us remember the words of John, of the letter to St. John. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And in the Acts, the community of believers was of one heart and one mind. Brothers and sisters, let each of us be of one heart and one mind. Amen. And now together let us profess what we truly believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, born of the Father. Brothers and sisters, we have not seen but still believe. With confident faith, we bring our concerns before God.
That the newly baptized and newly received find church both welcome and challenge, we pray to the Lord.
O God, hear us, hear our prayer.
That those seeking an increase in faith will grow in certainty that God's divine mercy is abundant beyond human imagination. We pray to the Lord.
Oh God, hear us, hear our prayer.
That members of this community strive to be one of heart and one mind in the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Oh God, hear us, hear our prayer.
That those who respond generously to our Catholic appeal will experience the joy given to God's faithful stewards. We pray to the Lord.
Oh God, hear us, hear our prayer.
For those in the armed forces and the first responders, that God's divine mercy may guide their efforts. We pray to the Lord.
Oh God, hear us, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died recently, especially Mary Lou Habala, Bill Smith, Judith McLean, Carl Tattaglia, Christine Raposo, and others listed on our parish prayer wall, as well as those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Oh God, hear us, hear our prayer.
Generous God, plant your precious gift of faith ever deeper in our hearts. All this we ask in the name of Jesus, who is our Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Gifts are brought to the altar. Please join in singing number 176, Ye Sons and Daughters, number 176.
Alleluia. Hallelujah, hallelujah. break of day, the faithful women went their way to seek the tomb where Jesus lay. Alleluia.
Dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for those of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all to love you, but above this day, above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, all you created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, grace you make holy these gifts we have brought for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, and that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Timothy, our patron, and with all the saints in his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church, your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. They hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord. that you may bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, both now and forever, from now until the end of time.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace you grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Go get the book off.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I'm not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song from the music issue is number 473, All Is Well With My Soul, number 473.
God, I will bless you as long.
makes me whole. With gladness and joy, I will sing of your name. All is well, all is well with my soul. All is well with my soul. All is well, all is well with my soul.
Second communion song is number 475, Eye Has Not Seen, number 475.
Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has readied for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. When pain and sorrow weigh us down, be near to us, O Lord. Forgive the weakness of our faith and bear us up within your peaceful word. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has readied for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. Our lives are but a single breath. We flower and we fade. Yet all our days are in your hands, so we return in love what love has made. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has readied for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. To those who see with eyes of faith, the Lord is ever near. Reflected in the faces of all the poor and lowly of the world. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has readied for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. We sing a mystery from the past, in halls where saints have trod. Yet ever new the music rings to Jesus' living song of God. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has readied for those who love him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God.
Thank you. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and our hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow your head and pray for God's blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
Amen. May he who, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
A closing song from the music issue is number 577, The Strife is O'er, number 577.
The strife is